I've always had a fascination with ancient and unusual animals of the past. I think it's a curiosity that many of us share about the animals that once walked the earth in which we stand upon today. Hello, I'm Safari Jeff. I'm holding an African bullfrog, which is one of the largest of amphibians on the planet. At a full-grown size, these creatures can grow to be as big around as a basketball. And it's no wonder I have such an interest in herpetology, the study of reptiles and amphibians. These are some of the most successful of the animal kingdom, some of the most ancient. Fossils tell a history of our Earth's past. And the Carboniferous period was the time of the amphibian, into the Permian era as well, and it wasn't until the late Triassic when reptiles came into play. The turtles were amongst the earliest of life forms, adapting to life on our planet alongside of crocodiles and alligators. And some of the earliest of turtle species to grace the Earth consisted of the soft shell variety. You can almost feel and see the texture of the skin which covered the carapace of this ancient soft-shell turtle so many millions of years ago. And still today, much like turtles of modern times, they too had a skeletal structure fused to the inside of their shell. A rib cage and modification of their bones gave it the armor plating it needed to survive, adapt, and succeed. The turtles would rarely leave the water only to lay their eggs at times of the year. And it wasn't until the later Jurassic period when dinosaurs came into play, dominating the landscape. Some of these creatures were considered to be top predators, nonetheless. Still today, we discover many fossils and bones scattered across the Midwestern landscapes of the Badlands. This fossilized bone of the Albertosaurus, as seen here, shows us that these ancient carnivorous creatures came equipped with hollow bones. Lightweight, much like birds of today, they would move quickly and had a great ability to catch their prey, or even leap into the air, perhaps. So it's no wonder that during the later Jurassic periods, many reptiles and amphibians adapted to life by gliding or flying. Amazing. Still today, we discover many species of gliding reptile around the world. These are some of the most unique of the animal kingdom. Well, thanks for joining me once again here on Safari Jeff TV. You've been watching another chapter in our ancient history and some of the most unusual animals that ever graced the landscape on planet Earth.